We're not going to give up, and we're not going to give in. We're going to continue to fight, and we got to learn how to compete. We don't know how to compete yet, and it's all about pride. You have to have pride in yourself, and it's a very competitive sport. This is a game of life, but you got to know when things aren't going right that someone has to step up, and that's what we're not getting right now.
Texas is now 1-4 this season, the team's worst record through five games since 1956, a very long time ago. Clearly, this isn't what Longhorn fans are accustomed to. Stephen A., what should Texas do?
Well, Texas should wait until the season's over, and then they should replace Charlie Strong.
Wow.
But I want to make sure I clarify my comments, because I think people are misconstruing what I'm saying. And I was talking to Mike and Mike yesterday, and I called in about it. In no way am I questioning the football acumen or the coaching ability of Charlie Strong. I am just saying that the odds are stacked against him. Look at the handwriting on the wall and understand when it's your time to go. That's all I mean by this. If Texas was a place where they were not used to success, mm-hmm. where there was patience, where there was a long-term plan, I've got nothing to say. This is par for the course. Look at what Charlie Strong had to come in there and do. He had to get rid of like 9 or 10 different players because they were bad guys in the locker room. You know, they were leadership issues. They were Matt Brown lovers. They were guys that wanted to do things a certain way and didn't want to do things his way. And behind the coach's back were encouraging dudes to do things differently. So you had to get rid of those guys. We get all of that, okay? So you went 6-7 last year. Now, granted, Matt Brown didn't have the greatest years. 9-4, 8-5, two of the last 3 years, stuff like that. Had one season where he went 5-7. I think that was back in 2010, if I remember correctly. But prior to that, it was religiously 10-11 win seasons. And one time it was, you know, 13-1 national title, championship game appearance. I am simply saying that even though there was time for a change and Charlie Strong seemed like the good candidate, here's where you run into a problem. You were not only 6-7 last year, but you get blown out by TCU. Your only victory came, I mean, who was that again? Was that
Rice?
It was Rice, right? Yeah. That was about it. Nobody else did they beat. And then I'm looking at it and I'm saying, well, wait a minute here. And this is where it really hit me. When you talk about their ranking in terms of recruiting, they're getting out recruited by Texas A&M, of course. TCU, Baylor, Houston. The University of Houston is outranking them in recruiting. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Texas.
But he hasn't been given a four-year recruiting cycle.
Wait a minute. This is Texas. Let me use, because I got some relatives in Texas. Let me use my southern drawl here. Texas. This is what I'm talking about.
Well, you got to work on that.
We have to work on it. How do? Okay. Here's the deal. I love the folks in Texas. I'm not being derogatory here. I'm saying to you, it's Houston. We're talking oil money. We're talking Texas. We're talking Austin, Texas. We're talking the Texas Longhorns. And you're being out-recruited by Houston? What I'm saying to you is this. This ain't about Charlie Strong, the competent coach. I believe in this man. I believe under better circumstances he should stay. But the AD who hired him obviously hired him against the wishes of a bunch of boosters, alumni members, etc. They're coming out now and publicly declaring they support Charlie Strong. But you know this better than me. Behind his back, with all of these struggles going on, they want that man out of there. They just don't want to look like the bad guy. Nobody's a fool here. We can see the handwriting on the wall. So my point was, not only is that going on, not only is your number one supporter, the AD, gone, but on top of it all, you're looking bad because with all of these first-class facilities and the resources that you have, which are second to none, you are getting out-recruited by all of these other universities in Texas?
Mm-hmm.
That is a problem.
Yep.
And I'm saying, see the handwriting on the wall? They ain't going to support you, Charlie Strong. I don't care what they say. Get the hell out of there. Get out of there as quick, fast, and in a hurry. Go to Miami. I mean, and not only that, this is what they're going to use, Skip. You tell me this because you know, listen, I know college football because of you, my man. Come on now. You don't want to got me started watching
especially
it religiously.
Know this college
that's
football.
Right. Yeah. Look at what McElwain is doing at Florida.
Uh-huh.
Man's undefeated. it. He is flat out balling, okay?
I think that cupboard was not there when he took over.
That's right.
It was full.
And look at Windham in Utah. Mm-hmm. I mean, look at what they're doing. They're number fifth ranked team in the nation. And Charlie Strong, 1-4.
Okay.
Winless in a
quick question. I got to acknowledge the obvious elephant in our living room.
Sure.
As you often remind me, you are a black man, and you're talking about one of the few black head coaches in college football, and you're saying after a year and not even a half, he's got to be gone.
I'm trying to tell you right now. I keep trying to tell America, folks, don't listen to me.
Okay.
I'm a fair-minded dude.
Yes, you are.
Listen, I'm the guy that sat there and said Lovie Smith don't need to be in Chicago anymore.
That was after many years.
I didn't say he needed to not be a head coach. I said he needed to be out of Chicago.
And Marvin Lewis, you have said.
Come on now, 12 years, you can't win a playoff game. Okay. I'm going to call what it is.
Thank you.
But I look at Charlie Strong. I think Charlie Strong should be a head coach of Miami. I think he should be a head coach at various other institutions. I'm just saying, Texas, look at the handwriting on the wall, Charlie. They're going to get rid of you, bro. They owe him a bunch of money now. They're going to have to get at least 15 million from what I heard, not to mention his assistants. Man, they can write that thing off. They can sit there and pay you and spread it out a few years. But look at the handwriting on the wall, Charlie. They're going to get rid of you. Get out as fast as you can. It's a bad situation for him. That's what I mean. I'm not saying, be fired because you can't coach. I'm saying he needs to go because they never wanted him there to begin with, and the struggles, they're not going to stand by him. And now you got freshmen sitting up there texting at hat in the middle of a game about how, whether or not he should transfer. Look, that's happening because guys, they're imploding. You know when you implode, Skip? When you know that your head coach doesn't have the support, because if he did, you would toe the line.
You're not
toeing the line because you know there are whispers out there about how people don't want
also reports of internal dissension.
Yes.
The freshman class going back and forth with the upperclassmen.
That's right.
A lot of friction there.
And by the way, Charlie Strong should take over the defense because that's his signature anyway. Nobody knows the defense
better
than him.
Before I get into my answer, that's the only really bad sign here.
That's right.
Charlie Strong can coach the heck out of defense because he did it at Florida
and
he did it at Louisville. And he did it as a coordinator and a head coach.
That's right.
And then I'm looking at, wait a second, Charlie, on national TV early on, you give up 38 at Notre Dame.
Yep.
Then you give up 45 at home to
Cal.
And then you give up 30 at home to Oklahoma State.
Yeah.
And then you give up 41 at TCU.
And by the way, everybody was acting like that was such a big deal at how they lost to Cal because the extra point was missed. My thing was, what the hell are you doing giving up 45 points?
45 at home. Now that Jared Goff can play. We'll get into him later.
45 though.
Okay. Let me just declare myself here because obviously I was born and raised a University of Oklahoma fan. They play this weekend in the Cotton Bowl, arch rival.
10th ranked in the nation.
I was taught at an early age to hate everything Texas, University of Texas. So that is mitigated by the fact we have twice had Charlie Strong sit in the seat on this show. And you know what?
Good man.
I clicked with him. I liked the heck out of him.
I liked him too.
You know, and so maybe I've lost some objectivity that way.
Mm-hmm.
But I do think he deserves the rest of this year.
Yeah.
This is just me. Just me. I think he even deserves next year. And I know the signs are horrible here. And remember, they still have to play my Sooners, and they are now 17-point underdogs at the Cotton Bowl. Then they have to go to West Virginia. Listen, West Virginia is pretty good. And then they end up having to go to Baylor, which has been obliterating people. So it could get worse. And maybe some of those major donors who were reportedly yesterday still on Charlie's side, maybe they'll turn on him. They could turn on if Texas loses 41 to whatever it was to TC, 41 to 10 to Oklahoma, we might get a different story from the major donors.
But let me be very, very clear. I'm not saying that Charlie Strong should be fired right now, shouldn't be allowed to complete the season. I'm not saying he doesn't deserve to have a long-term opportunity to build this program. What I'm saying is the struggles that he's having at this particular university, which ain't trying to rebuild, which ain't trying to wait, which ain't trying to have a long-term plan, and you combine it with the fact that you in Texas, and they didn't want you there to begin with.
You're saying it's more the situation.
It's the situation.
Yeah.
Look, Charlie Strong, see the handwriting on the wall and get the hell out of there.
All right.
That's what I'm saying.
Okay, well, are you blaming Texas more than Charlie Strong?
Well, I'm blaming them from the perspective that I think that there were whispers from the time he got there that they didn't want him there. When you combine that with the changes that he ultimately had to make, where he had to be and he spoke very highly of Mack Brown, and we all think highly of Mack Brown, but the bottom line is he had to be sort of the anti-Mack Brown.
Did.
Do you see who Mack Brown is? Have you met a nicer guy?
No.
I mean, mean, my God, he's just a sweetheart of a guy.
Yep.
Well, that's not Charlie Strong.
Nope.
He's not a bad guy.
No,
Charlie Strong is
a
good
tough guy.
But he's a tough guy. He's a disciplinarian. Well, who's going to understand that transition slower than kids? Kids are going to be, I'm not used to this. I didn't come here for this.
Yeah.
I came here for Mac Brown. I didn't come here for this. So it's a struggle for them.
Yep.
And I'm like, look, you don't have the time. Even though you have the resources, you're surrounded by people who really want you to fail. And there are great opportunities for you elsewhere. Because no matter how much you, even if you win at Texas, when you're surrounded by people who don't want you around, well, you take it when the opportunity is just so great until something just as great, if not greater, comes
along. Okay, all right.
That's all I'm saying.
Okay, he did get one huge break. The AD who hired him, Steve Patterson,
yes,
had alienated so many of the major donors that he got fired after just 2 years.
That's right.
And it was such a PR nightmare for that school that I think it would look even worse if then at the end of this year you remove Charlie Strong. So I think he has a little PR cachet just because that guy made such a mess of the athletic department.
I don't believe Charlie Strong has any PR cachet in Texas.
Well, it's by default.
And you know this better than me. All that matters at Texas is Texas.
Okay.
They don't care how the outside world feels.
Okay,
football country.
They, that's who they are.
Last quick point, being totally objective. Mm-hmm. Charlie Strong did one thing in in-game strategy that really did rankle, I'm sure, a lot of Texas fans. And that was in their first conference game at home against Oklahoma State, who's a pretty good football team. They had them on the ropes. That's why. Remember, they had Cal and Oklahoma State on the ropes. Those are two pretty good teams, so let's give him that. Even though you're giving up a lot of points, you're also, because the young quarterback, Gerard Hurd, is pretty good. I like him. He's not a good thrower, but he can. Man, you talk about Russell Wilson. This kid's got Russell Wilson all over him.
Okay.
So you're in the game against Oklahoma State, maybe in control of the game. I watched the whole game. Oklahoma State has the football and is driving for the tying field goal, and Charlie Strong got a 15-yard unsportsmanlike conduct penalty for arguing with the ref and set up the tying field goal. See, that's the kind of thing under this kind of stressful pressure. You cannot do that.
There you go.
Okay.
There you go.
All
just
right.
The latest example to support what I'm saying.
All right.
He just needs to go elsewhere. I'm not questioning his coaching ability, whether or not he deserves to be a head coach. I know he does.
Okay.
Okay? He just don't need to be there.
Okay. Well, I hope Shaq is smart in basketball. I hope he gets off to a better start.
I was getting ready to say that. It's even more pressure on Shaq is smart.
I know.
Because of the whole Charlie Strong situation. But I have no doubt Shaq
is
smart going to tear it up. Shaq is smart going to do his thing. All you need is basketball. This ain't football. All you need is two players. And Shaq is smart will get them at the University of Texas.
Well, all you need to do is press like crazy, and they will press.
Shaq is smart is going to do a hell of a job for that basketball program. You mark my words.
He's legit. We'll all be watching 11 a.m. on ABC, Texas, Oklahoma, the Red River rivalry. We stay in the South. Things are getting heated down in South Beach as well. The Dolphins fired their head coach. We told you that yesterday. And now their quarterback is speaking out on his team. We'll fill you in and react to that next.